So you probably have been presenting for a long while now, and you've always wanted to do something that you know can improve how much you present information to audiences, how much you present yourself, your ideas to people. So whether it is public speaking, maybe PowerPoint, maybe even having confidence to talk on camera. And for some people, they will never turn on their video in this in this training, not because they don't like themselves, but because they just don't like how they look on camera. So how to actually have that confidence, how to, of course, I help people overcome fear, live free from anxiety. Because of that, I've realized that sometimes it also affects people who train, people who work with people and all that. So this is actually the main training. That's all I'm trying to say. I'm not trying to sell you anything here. So let's just jump right in. Oh, if you're like, says, oh, wow, thank you, amazing. Oh, if you're using my language. And Balanle says, thanks, coach. Thank you very much, too. Thank you for being here. So let's jump right in as we look at speaking with confidence, power, and poise. And I'm going to be walking you through a model that I created that helps people to actually master confidence. Anytime anybody says, I lack confidence, it often comes down to three things. The first one is, how can I make this thing go up now? How can I make this thing go up? So let me see. Okay. If I click it like this, will it go up? Okay, good. That's gone up. So there are three, all forms of confidence, all confidence comes down to three things. And the three things are basically, number one, self. Number two, social. And number three, skills. Now, I call this the Dayo Samuel's confidence compass. Now, just before I jump right in and walk you through that, if you notice with your phone, if you are like me that we use a smartphone, some people, their phones are smarter than they are anyway. If you're like me and you use a smartphone, you probably notice that there is an app on your phone called Compass. A lot of people don't actually know that that exists on their phones, but I'm going to open up that app right now and show you what Compass actually looks like. So here's what a compass is. It's asking to turn on my, so here's how a compass looks like. So you see there's a red cardinal point, and there is a, and if you look at it here, you notice the more I'm turning it, the more it's turning. The more I'm turning, the more it's turning. Now, in your personal life, and just as this confidence is, a lot of the times we are moving in the direction of two particular spots on this compass. And how do I mean by that? If you, maybe after now, you actually carry your phone, and then you look at your phone, you will observe that there are two spots here. You notice that there's one red spot and then there is one gray spot. Let me try and turn and turn and turn so that, okay, I'm going to try and turn. I'm trying to turn so that the two arrows can actually merge. Now, you notice I'm trying to run after the two. Let me cancel that. Sorry for that notification. But what I want you to observe is this. There's a red arrow here. There's a red arrow here. And then there's a gray arrow here. Now, this gray arrow is what's called the true north, while this red arrow is called the compass north. Now, every time you are moving in a direction, the compass tries to align with the true north. Your magnetic north, which is the red one, always try to adjust so that it matches with the true north. Now, what am I trying to explain here? Basically, what I'm trying to get you to become aware of is that just like this normal compass, your confidence moves in a direction per time, and depending on where you are, depending on what your emphasis is per time, your confidence will most likely move in that direction. And what makes up confidence, I think my screen is getting too bright now, so let me just put some darkness into this place. Just hold on, let me just. So as I was explaining, the confidence that you have per time will tilt in a direction based on where you are at that point in time. So here are the three points on that compass. The first point is what I call self. The first point is what I call self. The second point is social. And the third point is skills. Now, with social with self, for example, for you to have confidence when it comes to self, what you need is what I call congruence. And what does congruence mean? Self-confidence is basically the confidence you have in yourself, in you as a person, not in your ability, not in your relationship with other people. Social has to do with your relationship with other people, and skills has to do with the confidence you have in your ability to do certain things. So confidence in yourself doesn't have to do with ability. Skills is what has to do with ability. Self has to do with that level you get to where, and what congruence actually means is that level where you get to, where your inner world is the same thing as your outer world. That means that you are not somebody on the inside and you are not the person on the outside, because actually, how does that affect you? If you are incongruent, if your inner self and your outer self don't have a place of alignment, what you find is that sometimes you appear A to some people and then you appear B to some people. Why? Because there's this dissonance happening within yourself. There's this dissonance happening within you, such that sometimes you do things and then you say things or you behave in a certain way and people wonder, really? Is it that guy? So the point of congruence is when your inner self comes in alignment, into an agreement with your outer self. And then social has to do with your relationship with other people. Social basically means your ability to relate with other people effectively. And that's why I refer to it as connection, the connection you maintain with other people. And the third part here has to do with your skills, your ability to do certain things well. God has given everybody the ability to do certain things well. So that refers to what I call your competence. Now, in psychology, there's something called the competence-confidence loop. What that means is that the better you get at something, the more confident you get at that thing. The better you get at something, the more confidence you have in yourself. The better you get at doing a particular task, the more confidence you have in yourself. So if you think about it right now, everything that you know about confidence comes down to three things. And the interesting thing is that when you have self incongruence and you have high skills, what happens is people praise you for what you do, because they say, ah, that guy, he knows himself very well and he knows how to do that thing very well. But of course, you will probably not have relationship with people, or maybe you have certain relationships with people and some relationships will not be that effective. And when you have skills and you have social, that is, you are very good with relating with people and you have very good skills, what you then have is what I call performance. You have very good performance because, of course, you do the skills, you do the things you know how to do in order to show off to people, in order to appear great, in order to appear powerful in front of people. But then when you get to the point where you know yourself very well, you understand yourself very well, and you have a balanced relationship with other people, what you have is presence. That is, you're able to control how much input people have in your life. You're able to control how much of yourself you give away. You learn to say no when it's the right time to actually say no. So all confidence, again, comes down to these three things. And the reason why I'm sharing this here is because if you don't understand the area where you tilt to at this point in your time, is it more of self-confidence you have and you have low skills confidence? Is it more of self-confidence you are tilting towards, that is your magnetic north, or your, of course, your compass north is moving towards self. And so because you are moving towards self, you are neglecting social, you are neglecting skills. Now, the interesting thing is that if you learn how to manage the three of them very well, what you have is a balance. So you have what's called balance at the center here. So you have a balanced confidence at the center. So when I work with people, one of the things I tell them is, because I have an assessment that people take to identify where they are in this compass. Now, I once worked with somebody and the person identified himself as very skillful and then very social. At that point, he realized that he actually doesn't believe in himself. That's why sometimes when he needs to do certain things, even though he knows how to do it very, very well, but because he doesn't believe in himself, and that hinders his ability to do that, and that hinders his is ability to relate with other people. Now, if this is something that's helpful to you, please say yes in the comment. Let me know that this is helpful to you. Now, what have you learned from this so far? Was it helpful to you? How helpful is this to you? What did you discover from learning about the confidence compass right now? Okay, he says yes. And so what did you learn from that? What did you learn from that? Looks like if he is typing. So what did you learn from that? Okay, thank you for those that are typing. Thank you for those that are typing. Thank you.